Good afternoon to all. My name is Mansi Siwal. I'm here to present my poster presentation on cyber stalking, a bane arising with a progressing technology. Cyber stalking is a serious predatory behavior that arises from the evolutionary need for controlling in the pursuit of resource and reputation. It also refers to electronic means of intrusion. It is the use of the internet or other electronic means to stalk or harass an individual, a group, or an organization. It may include monitoring, identity theft, threats, vandalism, solicitation for sex, or gathering information that may be used to threaten or harass. The COVID-19 pandemic has certainly turned all the work meetings done from home, which in turn physical stalking into virtual stalking. It's now easier to stalk people because there are so many applications, stalkware, spyware, social media tool, etc. Online stalking is the most common among the young generation who spend more time on social media and on the dating sites. Young adults aged between 18 to 24, particularly women, are at the higher risk. So now comes, who are the victims of the cybercrime? They can be prior inmates who had previous intimate relationship with a stalker. They can be casual acquaintances and friends, which include stalking in under neighborhood, can be workplace contacts or the person working in the same department, can be business partners. It can be close friends, far friends, and last but not the least, it can be strangers. So now the cyber stalker categorization comes in screen. So starting from the first, rejected cyber stalkers. These offenders either feel misunderstood, hoping to reverse the breakup, or feel angry and seeking revenge because their attempts at reconciliation with the victim has failed in the past. The second category is resentful cyber stalkers. They are the fully aware that victim is cognizant of the stalking, but continues to fulfill a distorted vendetta he should feel is warranted. Fear and distress experienced by the victim are the goals of this type of cyber stalker. The third one is intimacy seekers cyber stalker. This type of cyber stalker does not have ill will towards their victim and simply wants to engage in a loving relationship with them. Intimacy seeking cyber stalker, they are often the segment of men and women who harass celebrities and public figures too. The fourth category is incompetent suitors. These people who fit this profile are cyber stalkers, deeply associated with their victim, and their interest for the victim at times can reach a state of fixation whereby their entire waking life is focused on the endeavor of one day becoming a couple. And the last, out of all the categories of cyber stalker, predatory cyber stalker, they are the most dangerous and determined. This type of cyber stalker is motivated by a perverted sexual need. They engage in actively planning an attack along with fantasizing about the sexual acts with their victims. Now, in what forms of cyber stalker harassing someone or victim? It can be in the form of electronic messages, such as emails, text messages on Twitter, spamming or sending threatening emails to the victim, posting offensive comments in the victim's name, creating and posting sexual explicit images of the victim or victim's loved ones, attaching spyware to the emails or installing it on the computer by hacking the system of the victim. The cybercrime, basically the cyber stalking, would lead to many adverse effects on the victim. They become angry, annoyed, anxious, helpless, depressed. They have trouble in sleeping, feeling of uncertainty and unpredictability arising. In India, to dealing with cyber stalking crimes, there are strict laws against them. The first is under Section 67 of the Information Act, Information Technology Act 2000. It punishes a stalker who sends or causes to send or publish obscene posts or content on electronic media with imprisonment up to 3 years and a fine too. Second one is the Section 354D of the Indian Penal Code 1860. It makes punishable the offense of stalking too. In the first time offenders, it is bailable, but in the second time, if the repeated offender was found, it will be non-bailable. And the third one is a Section 354C of Information Technology Act, which I forget to mention in my poster. It deals with voyeurism. Voyeurism basically the sexual interest in or practice of spying on people engaging in intimate relationship or behavior such as undressing, some sexual private actions. So at the last of my presentation, it is said that how we can prevent this from happening. So we can prevent this by protecting all our accounts password, by keeping it on strong, consist of alphanumeric characters, reduce the amount of information available about ourselves online, and never disclose our banking details to anyone. Always install licensed antivirus software to the system, and never reveal our phone number, home address on social media. If we are leaving a partner, spouse, or whom we shared our passwords, our important social media details, always change our passwords and further details, set them as they can't guess them. So that's all, and thank you for listening to me.